And then we spoke about Adam and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam. And we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from His powers and strength that if He wants something to happen, all Allah azza wa jal will do is say, kun fayakun, be and it happens. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to create Adam, all Allah azza wa jal will do is say, become Adam, and Adam becomes. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not do it this way. Allah azza wa jal created Adam gradually. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam in stages. Some scholars say, this is for us as mankind to understand and realize that everything in life comes gradually. Everything in life comes step by stages. Because this human being has this rush in them. They want things to be quick and rush into things. We want things to happen in one day and night. I want to be strong, so strong in one day and night. One day's training at the gym. I want to be smart and so knowledgeable in one day's lesson. I want to be rich in one day's work. And I want to be this, all this in seconds. This is the nature of the human being. The nature of the human being loves things to come to him so quick. Loves things to come to him so quick and things happen to him so quick. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that can do this within two letters, kun fayakun, will happen. And Allah azza wa jalla didn't do it that quick. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't do it all at once. When Allah can. But this for us to understand that everything comes in life gradually. And we mentioned the story when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blew the soul on Adam. And then the soul came to his nose and he sneezed. And then the angels told him, say alhamdulillah. So Allah azza wa jalla told him, yarhamuka rabbuk, may your Lord have mercy on you. And then when the soul came to his stomach, and he was standing in the paradise and he saw the fruits of the paradise, he started to desire those fruits. And before the soul reaching his feet, Adam wanted to jump and go and get those fruits. So Allah Azza wa Jal, he said, خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ عَجُولًا. The insan had been created in quick and rush. The Adam, before the soul reached his feet, Adam wanted to take those fruits. But it's the nature of the human being. And as I mentioned, we look into how Allah created this human being. Allah created him gradually. When Allah can create him so quick, in a split of a second, in an order of kun fayakun, and Allah Azza wa Jalla didn't do it. So this is for us to learn and to understand. And then it was the evil shaitan, the enemy of this human being, that's been an enemy of this human being before the completion of this human being, before Allah Azza wa Jal blew the soul in him. And Iblis had promised that if Allah Azza wa Jal lets him on this human being, he'll destroy this human being. And then it was that time that Adam lived in the paradise, and that's where we stopped at last week. Adam alayhi salam, the first human being that Allah Azza wa Jal had created, and the grandfather of mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had created him in a massive, gigantic structure. It was over 30 meters tall. Some scholars say 60 meters tall. Other scholars say even more than that. But now that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said it was 60 arms length. And each arm length, it's 50 centimeters. So he's gigantic. He's so tall. So he's as tall as a high-rise building. And he was 7 arms length wide. It's about 3 meters and a half, if not more. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, and mankind had been decreasing their height ever since then. This is what the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam said. Mankind had been decreasing the height ever since then. Now, we are as tall as what? 10% of what Adam used to be. We are 10% of the height of what Adam used to be. And Adam alayhi salam was a righteous, God-fearing, servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him live in the paradise.